What's up everybody, Eric Merced here, and in today's video, I am going to show you how to create a Captain America shield using Procreate's new shape features.
Okay, so for this tutorial, we're going to be creating the same exact shield that you see here in Procreate using Procreate's new shape features. And I'm going to take you step by step on how I got this particular shield done in Procreate. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to get out of here and go back to our main gallery page, and we're going to create a new document, and we're just going to keep it at a square by 9, so 9 inches by 9 inches, just to keep it simple. Now you can use any brushes you want, like the Procreate default brushes, but throughout this tutorial I'm going to be using my brushes, which I've created, for the Pro Inkers set. So the first brush I'm going to use to create my shapes is I'm going to go to the Pro Inkers, and I'm going to use the lettering pen, and I'm going to just have it at black. It doesn't really matter. And I'm going to have it at the lowest size possible. So the first thing I'm going to do is create a circle and center it in the page itself. Now I'm going to do the circle freehand, but what I'm going to do is I draw the circle. I'm going to make sure it closes. And when Procreate creates an ellipse for me, I'm going to go ahead and touch with my other finger to make sure it straightens out. I'm going to make it about that size right there. So this is going to be the base shape of the shield. This is the size of the shield. We can go ahead and transform this and just move it around, make it more centered. So now with the base shape, I'm going to go ahead and create a new layer. And I'm going to create the inner border of the shape using the same method. Now to make sure my shape is where it's supposed to be, I'm going to hit Edit Shape and just move it around and center it. Again, I'm going to create a new layer and do the same exact thing for the inner border. So at this point, we should have three layers, starting with layer number one, which is our base layer. Layer number two is our inner border. And layer number three is our innermost centered border. We're going to go ahead and create another layer. And in this layer, we're going to do our star. Now there's two ways to go about this. The first one is just to go ahead and draw the star. And then just edit the shape using Procreate's shape tool. Of course, you can draw a better star than that and get it more accurate. The second way to do it is to use shape brushes. Now I have a set of shape brushes that I'm going to use just to make the process a little quicker. It doesn't really matter that the border of the star is thicker than the other shapes. You'll see why in a couple of seconds. With all of these shapes drawn, I'm going to go ahead and combine these layers. And I'm just going to rename them to line art. Now I'm going to create a new layer, and this is where our coloring is going to take place. So before I begin coloring, I'm going to go ahead and change my background color to a different color. So for this, I'm just going to choose gray, just so we can see what's going on a little bit better. Next, I'm going to go back into my line art, and I'm going to choose layer one, or my base layer. And I'm going to tap on it and choose reference. Now I'll go back to my layer six, which is my color layer. I'm going to choose a red color and drop that red color into the base. And you'll see that that'll automatically flood the entire shape. Now to make sure you get those corners, I'm going to go ahead, flood it, and make sure my threshold, color drop threshold, is up as high as I can take it. We can even take the line art and put it above the color, just so we can see what we're doing. So I'm going to do another layer, layer 7. I'm going to choose a white color. We're going to go back to my line art layers and choose layer 2 as my reference layer. Go back to layer 7 and drop that white color in between, just like so. And again, this is a process of do, repeat, do, repeat. So I'm going to go back to my inks, to my line art layers, and choose layer 3 as my reference. Create a new layer, choose that red color again, and again, create a new layer, choose a blue color, I'm going to go back into my line art, choose the star as my reference, create a new layer, choose the color white, and drop that into the star layer. So now all of our base colors are created. Let's make things a little easier by cleaning this up and choosing all of our color layers and grouping them. We can go ahead and rename this to colors. So now if we go ahead and turn off our line art, we're going to see that we pretty much have a nicely flatted shield without the lines. At this point on, we really don't need the lines. The lines were there just to help us fill out the colors. So now we're going to go into shading. I'm going to choose my base layer, which is layer 6. I'm going to choose to create a new layer above that. I'm going to set that layer to multiply. And instead of choosing red, I'm going to choose a purple color. Again, you can use any brushes you want here, but I'm going to use my Pro Air brushers to color this in. Now I'm going to choose that layer and choose clipping mask. And I'm going to do the same thing with every other layer. Okay, so my shading is done. Let's go ahead and add a little bit of variety to this by adding some highlight color. Alright, and finally, the last thing I'm going to do is to add a drop shadow just to make the shield pop from the page. So in order to do that, we're going to go back to our base layer. We're going to choose to duplicate it. We're going to turn our alpha lock on that layer and choose a black color and fill the layer. Now we can turn the alpha lock off. Next, we're going to choose transform and move that layer a little to the side, right where our shadow is dropping, like so. To finish it off, we're going to go ahead and choose in adjustments, Gaussian blur. Just like so. And we're then going to lower the opacity of that layer so it won't be so overpowering. And there you go.
So that's it. That's how easy you can create a Captain America shield in Procreate using Procreate's new awesome shape features. I hope you guys liked this video, and if you did, go ahead and hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. And if you want to keep up to date with all the new videos I post, go ahead and hit the notification icon. Thanks guys for watching. I will see you all in the next video. Peace.